Okay, here you can see I have finished welding and joining this metal together after cutting out this 2 3/4 inch section. A couple of things that I wanted to show you guys. First of all, I had to recreate the bead, the edge bead along here. Not exactly easy, but you know, it was mandatory to get that to get the correct edge look, to get that line in the, you know, the correct bead. Can't just hack off the metal and leave it uncrimped. You got to crimp it over. So I replicated the original crimp. I basically, because they didn't meet up, obviously right here, they're about 1.5 inches off. So from here to here, I sliced off about 1/4 inch of the metal and then rebent it using a piece of angle iron and a couple of vice grips and a hammer. I just bent it over 90 degrees and then smashed it flat on my anvil. Both sides. Same thing over here. You can see where that bead is recreated. And you can see here the metal work where I rejoined the metal from the backside first. Remember, small tacks. You can't do a fast bead all at once or you'll warp the hell out of the metal. Here's a couple of places where it got a little hot. This metal is flat now and these are just indentations. I'm going to lightly skim this with body fill. Probably most of it will be so thin you'll be able to almost see through it. Especially the top part here is, I mean, other than a few pits, this is just about perfect. I went over it with a DA sander. It's flat. I got good edges here, good body lines on either side. So basically, I'm going to grind the rest of the paint off. This thing's going to be ready for the texturing. There'll be a couple of spots like over here. There's a couple of little spots right there. I won't lick my metal flames across through there. I don't want to take the time and risk bending the metal more by trying to fill in with more weld, because I'm using a gasless MIG. I'm using flux core wire. So guys, you can do this without a TIG welder. I mean, this is good enough. I'll be able to get away with using the metal texture and it will still be flat. You can do it, it just takes time. Check out the tools here. You know, we're talking hand filing. Here's the angle iron that I used to bend to crimp the new edge over, and the vice grips, and I got a whole a dolly kit. This is all I needed. You know, I got my welder, gasless MIG, and you know, my DA sander and my angle grinder. This is the equipment that I use basically to refabricate this fender, and now it's a one of a kind. Nobody else has a fender that's like this. So, you know, I mean, don't let anybody tell you can't do this stuff. You know, don't let anybody tell you that you're crazy or that you don't have the skills. With practice and perseverance, you know, and just being patient, you can do this kind of metalwork right in your own garage. So that's a process. This is a good, you know, demonstration for typical metalwork for custom tins. Same rules of thumb apply on cars. You know, keep the heat low, keep the warpage to a minimum. If you have a MIG welder, just one spot at a time. You know, travel every couple inches, tack it, another couple inches, tack it, let it cool, and then move over to the next tack every 2 inches. Allow the metal to cool, don't allow it to get too hot, and you will get this nice, I mean, this is smooth, you know. This is not warped at all. It's hard to see on camera, but this metal, it's smooth. You know, I didn't warp it at all, just I was very, very patient. It took me all day to do this. So, taking this out and joining the two together, that's what you have. So, you know, this is good for, you know, posterity's sake, hanging on my wall, or, you know, chuck it over there and hit it in the trash, you know, whatever. So, the next step is to prep the metal and lay down the paint, which you've already seen in the other videos. So, this basically is the last tin other than the tank. I'm going to redo the tank, and then I'm going to show you guys the finished product.